from the Carrier Dome on the campus of Syracuse University. It's NCAA basketball on CBS today. The defending national champion Orangemen take on the Spartans from Michigan State. Hi, everybody. I'm Gus Johnson, along with my partner Clark Kellogg. And Syracuse has started their defense of their national championship. And although Carmelo Anthony is gone, they still have two great leading men in Jerry McNamara and Hakeem Warrick.
I just call them a point-producing pair. These guys average 36 points between them. McNamara takes care of it on the perimeter, 41% three-point shooting, and Hakeem Warrick does his damage around the paint. The Orangemen's dynamic duo. McNamara has a sweet stroke, and Hakeem Warrick is a high flyer who does most of his damage inside.
As for Michigan State, they come into this game with a 5-5 record. They've struggled a little bit, but Clark, they played the best and the baddest in the land.
They certainly have, Gus, and even though they've gone 0-5 against a very ambitious and aggressive schedule, they were only blown out in one game, and that was against Duke. They've had a chance in all four of the other games, but the reason they haven't won is because they've lacked tenacity on the glass, they've turned the ball over too much, and their defense has been spotty at best.
So coming up, it's the Big Ten versus the Big East. Michigan State, Syracuse on CBS next.
CBS Sports college basketball coverage is sponsored by Chevy Silverado. It's the right truck. Mountain Dew, the people who brought you Mountain Dew. And by DiGiorno. It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno.
The Carrier Dome, and we're rocking here in Syracuse. Tom Izzo in his ninth season at Michigan State. He's won a national championship back in 2000. And on the other sideline, Jim Boeheim, the Dean of Coaches in the Big East Conference, 28th season, and he's coming off a national championship on his own last year. As you take a look at the starting lineup for the Spartans, Paul Davis, the 6'11 sophomore, has gotten stronger. And on the other side, Hakeem Warrick, the 6'8 junior, has also gotten stronger. He's their leading scorer at close to 20 per game. Their officials, Jim Burr, Ed Corbett, and Curtis Shaw, the Carrier Dome. Here in Syracuse, New York, what should we pay attention to early in this game?
Well, a couple of things. One, this is the first real test for Syracuse against a quality opponent. How much zone defense will they play? They've been playing a lot of man prior to this game. And how effective defensively will the Spartans be?
Here's Pace with a turnaround jump shot in traffic. And Syracuse is on the board first as the Orange get back into that zone. Davis from 15. And the rebound goes to McNamara. Here comes Jerry McNamara, their second leading scorer at 16 per game. Edelin.
Can't let him in there. He is as potent as you'll find in the backcourt doing work in the paint. He's got all the little shots, the flips, the teardrops, the falling leaves, and he's physical enough to take hits and still finish. But this has been a problem for Michigan State in their 5-5 start. Too much dribble penetration by the opposition.
Fourth picks up the foul, and talking about Billy Eaglin, the sophomore from Silver Spring, Maryland. He had 28 points versus Canisius on 14 of 17 shooting. As Warrick is called for the foul, Chris Hill knocked to the floor.
Foul charge to Hakeem Warrick.
Chris Hill with a beautiful game against Syracuse last year when the two met in East Lansing.
34 points. He made 10 of 18 from behind the three-point line, and he's a guy you have to guard closely and try to make him become a driver instead of a catch-and-shoot player.
Syracuse winning the game 76-75. Here's McNamara, catch-and-shoot. And the rebound goes to the Spartans. Shannon Brown, a true freshman. Very nice athlete. There's number three. Inside, Davis splits the defense. Loose ball, rebounded by Warren. And here come the Orange. Edelin posting up. Beautiful look. Fourth up and in. Edelin has 34 assists on the season and has only turned it over six times in the last four games.
Well, this is a high-quality dime here, Gus. Over-the-shoulder pass as Forth was able to beat Andreas in transition. Not a full-blown fast break, but quick offense nonetheless. That's a terrific pass and a nice catch and finish by Forth. And right now, Michigan State on their heels a bit, Gus. They need to attack this zone with some dribble penetration and make sure they move the defense before they take their first shot.
Davis dumps it down. Brown, 18 on the shot clock, knocked away and stolen by Pace. Here come the Orange on the break. Edelin down low, up and in from Pace. And Syracuse takes a 9-0 lead.
Tom Izzo refraining from calling a timeout, wanting to see if his team, which has struggled so far this season, can fight through it, can work through the adversity of a poor start in this first 2 minutes and 25 seconds.
Edelin picks up the foul. Andreas steps out of the game. Torbert is one of the better athletes on this Michigan State squad, comes into the game. New shot clock for the Spartans.
Well, Gus, we got our answer to how much man-to-man Syracuse was going to play. None so far.
Zero. Anderson with the step on the baseline. Extra pass. Brown, beautiful release. And he knocks it down for three. And the Spartans are on the board.
Well, against the zone defense, after you've moved the ball, swung it from side to side, corner jump shots are available, because the defenders just can't quite cover from side to side in the corner.
McNamara, long rebound and a foul coming up at the top of the key. Looks like it goes against Davis, battling with Forth. And that'll be Davis's first.
Boy, Davis was doing a nice job there boxing out, but I think your guards have to come in and get those long rebounds, because he was boxing out almost at the foul line.
Exactly. Maurice Ager, who's been struggling with this shot, comes in for Michigan State. Warwick on the baseline, turns. The off-balance jumper is pure. Davis the other way from 18, and he rips one. Davis's confidence is growing game by game.
Well, he's got a lot of game, Gus. He's not really a true post-up big guy, but he can step away and shoot it facing, and the coaching staff is trying to get him to be more selective with his shots and be a little more aggressive when he does catch it in the
Forth
post.
Inside jams it down from Warren.
They're finding all kind of holes against the Michigan State defense. There's not much ball pressure, nor are the Spartans tagging the cutters.
In the corner, Torbert, partially blocked, rebounded by Edelin. Syracuse wants to run, and McNamara throws it out of bounds. Hakeem Warren
going to work. He's got an advantage in size on Allen Anderson and takes full advantage.
After 27 seasons, Jim Boeheim finally won the big one. That's the national championship trophy that sits in its office, and his former players are so happy for the coach.
All of our former players who helped us win and get to this point where we could win feel so good about it. Ronnie Cicely saying, "Coach, we finally got there," you know, and he's been gone from here for 15 years. So I think that's the best part of the whole experience. But, you know, college basketball, you get right back to reality, and the reality is, what are you doing right now? And, you know, we're not playing the way we need to play, and that's a big concern.
As you take a look at Jim Boeheim and a buddy of mine, Jason Cipolla, who lives around the corner from me in New York, a Syracuse alum, played shooting guard, was on that national runner-up team that lost to Kentucky, and he told me that all the alumni so happy to see their coach finally win the big one, Clark.
Yeah, it's a proud feeling for anybody associated with the program certainly the players who have played for Jim Boeheim, who's been here for almost three decades as a coach. And I think, again, that Boeheim, early in his career, was unfairly criticized as someone that had terrific players and didn't always maximize them. And I think that was so off base. But in the eyes of the masses, there's no way to deny his coaching ability when you win a national championship and you've been as good as his teams have been throughout his tenure here.
Hager crashing the boards hard and gets Michigan State on the board again, 13-7. Syracuse inside Ward. Great post position, partially blocked. Anderson in transition.
I think this is what Michigan has to do more of, Gus. They've got to defend well enough to force missed shots and then rebound the ball and try to get out in transition. Michigan State, I need to correct myself there as opposed to Michigan, was just there in Ann Arbor last week. Headed back there again next week.
Across the lane, and Warwick called for the foul for complete play-by-play information on top 25 games, including real-time scoring and stats. Click on NCAA Hoops at CBSSportsLine.com. 13-7, Syracuse. Michigan State has weathered the storm, so to speak, on the road here in Syracuse.
Beautiful pass there, Gus. Cross court, diagonal.
And as you mentioned, those corner jump shots will be open.
They will be there, Gus, and you've got to knock them down. That's a good, high-quality shot after you've made a couple of passes against the zone. And that's been one of the concerns for Tom Izzo. This team has gotten pretty good shots, and his better shooters just have not knocked them down consistently.
Foul away from the basketball. Looks like an elbow coming up against Andreas. And he will come out of the game, replaced by Davis. Pace along with Eatland, McNamara, fourth, and Warwick for Syracuse. Here's Warwick gobbling it up on the pivot across the lane, and he's fouled.
Well, this is a difficult matchup for Allen Anderson because he's giving up a couple of inches to Hakeem Warwick. They're trying to be physical with Warwick. He has gotten stronger since last year, but a nice job with his feet and with the ball fake to draw the foul.
Hakeem averaging 20 points per game on the season as the first one refuses to go down. What's the book on Hakeem Warwick?
Well, he's got great length, and he has gotten a little stronger from a year ago. He's like a blanket in that he covers a lot of space, especially at the defensive end, and then buckets. He's a scorer. He's got a number of good drop-step moves and a variety of shots down inside and along the baseline.
Syracuse up by seven. They get back into the zone. High pick and roll for Hill. Hager thinking about it. And that's a confidence builder. He's shooting 28% coming in this game, and he knocks down a jump shot from the hash mark.
When shooters are slumping, when they break out of it, it's an eruption.
Watch it.
It is an eruption when they break out of it. So keep an eye on Mo Hager, who has really struggled, but he was a key player for Michigan State last year when they made that nice run through the tournament.
Led them in scoring during the postseason is Pace with the Jamal Wilkes-style jump shot. In the corner, and Hager again, rebounded by Ford. Nice outlet pass, 2-on-1. Edelin, McNamara, up and in. And Syracuse takes an 8-point lead. Clark, this Billy Edelin is a serious basketball player.
He really is. I was talking to Troy Weaver, one of the assistants for Syracuse. He said he's a combination of Mark Jackson and Andre Miller. Physical guards who just understand how to play, get their own shot, but also help their teammates get shots.
Torbert, the reverse layup.
Nice job of attacking the zone by Michigan State. I thought that last corner jumper by Maurice Hager, a little too quick. You can get that shot after three or four passes, and when you miss it, if Syracuse rebounds out of the zone, then they're going to be able to attack you at the other end for transition scores.
Inside, and Warwick fouled.
Well, Syracuse has been all 2-3 zone, but we're going to take a look right here. That's Kelvin Torbert, who I actually circled. He gets behind the zone. Josh Pace is too high, and he's above his man. Didn't see him, and a good pass by Paul Davis.
Davis picks up his second foul. Cause for concern for Coach Izzo. Warwick, the numbers over the last four games. Second free throw good as well. 20-12. Syracuse. Now Johnson checks into the game. Rashi Johnson inside. Davis, extra pivot. Beautiful move. He got fourth in the air and draws a foul.
That's the kind of aggressiveness Tom Izzo would like to see from Paul Davis in the post. Ball fake, and did a nice job keeping the feet stationary after pivoting.
Misses the first. What's the book on Paul?
Well, let's take a look. Plenty of skill. He can shoot it facing. He's got a decent post-up game. He's got an excellent touch for a big guy. But I think he needs to get greedy. He's got to think about scoring more. When he catches it in the paint, think about scoring. When he catches it at the foul line, the defenders are off of him. He's got to be a guy that looks to score 16 to 18 points for this team, because his team needs that from him to maximize what they can be.
He's averaging 15 per game. Pace spinning down the lane and travels. Lost his footing. Now with the conclusion of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet most valuable player of the game from each team. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's General Scholarship Fund, a tradition for 30 years. So here comes Rashi Johnson in the front court, along with Ager, Davis, Brown, and Namek. They're trying to free Ager. Catches. Down the lane. Elevates. No. Loose ball, Brown with a rebound. No. Davis got a hand on it. And finally, Warwick clears it.
That time Syracuse went man-to-man, and Michigan State almost took advantage of the lack of blocking out, but just couldn't convert the tip-ins.
McNamara partially blocked. He's fouled. Looks like they got him on the wrist, and he should shoot three.
So far here in the early going, Michigan State doing a nice job of following their game plan as it relates to defending Jerry McNamara. They don't want to leave him. They want to challenge and contest all of his shots. And other than that foul, Michigan State has done a pretty good job of that.
And a rare miss for Jerry McNamara, an 86% free throw shooter. And here are the numbers for McNamara's first 2 years.
The assists are down because they don't have the same type of weapons they had a year ago, with Carmelo Anthony and Queth Dwayne being gone. And McNamara not cashing in from the strike, which is uncharacteristic for him. But one of the other things to keep an eye on too, Gus, while Michigan State has not settled on a consistent starting lineup, this is their seventh starting lineup. They do have more depth than Syracuse, and Tom Izzo trying to utilize that here in the first half.
Spartans want to wear them down. 21-13 Syracuse. Tom Izzo's Michigan State Spartans have taken on all comers. They haven't been as successful as they'd like, but they'll take it.
Confidence in players does diminish, you know, and I think when you have those games where you lose back to back to back, it begins to take a toll, and that's the big question. What's more important, confidence or competition? And, you know, the competition's been great, but the confidence is a little down when you don't win any of them.
And look at Michigan State. They were ranked as high as third, and that ranking has plummeted. But you told me before the game, as a matter of fact, yesterday, that you don't think that we should pay too much attention to the rankings until after the holidays.
Right, exactly. I think after Thanksgiving, sometime early to mid-December, after teams have had a chance to play a little bit, to get a chance to see teams, then I think a poll would actually have more merit than it does preseason, because basically you're speculating on what might be basing predictions on what teams may have returning. You never know how teams are going to come together and how they're going to perform once they get between the lines. So I love to see the polls not start until sometime after December 1.
But when you play Kansas, Duke, Oklahoma, Kentucky, and UCLA, you grow up in a hurry. And there is a lot more comfortable in foreign environments.
Yeah, exactly. I would very much favor competition over confidence. But like anything else in life, Gus, it's a balancing act. You've got to know your team, and the schedule is made up prior to each season, and sometimes well in advance. And you think about this Michigan State club, they were anticipating having Erasmus Lorbeck, a 6'11 multi-skilled power forward, to complement Paul Davis. And he abruptly decided to play professionally overseas.
Hill driving baseline, fouled by McNamara. Sunday on 60 Minutes is Country's Money, and the National Vodka carries his face. He renamed the month of April after his mom. Turkmenistan's dictator would be funny, except he's America's ally in the war on terror. Sunday on 60 Minutes after football. The Carrier Dome, 21-13, Syracuse. Ranked 17th in the nation against Michigan State. Johnson finds Hill, and Hill has been bottled up in this game. They're closing on him as soon as he touches the basketball.
Well, the scouting report on Hill, much the same as it is on Jerry McNamara. Crowd him and make sure you try not to give them open looks.
Crowd, the freshman, following his shot. And he put that first shot up there. And he came down with the rebound so clean, it almost surprised him.
Certainly surprised the Orangemen. But I've always said that when you miss a shot in close, you, the shooter, have the best chance to retrieve it because you know about how it came off your hands and where it might end up if it doesn't go in the hole.
Here's Johnson.
Somehow against this zone, Michigan State has to penetrate the seams and then try to get an open shot for Chris Hill.
Johnson down the lane, the kick, Hill, and he travels. He had Warwick on him, and Warwick is a shot blocker. Hill shuffled his feet.
We talked about the length of Akeem Warwick. And it was evident there because I thought Chris Hill had a look at a shot, but recognizing that Warwick was coming at him, he decided to try to go around him and committed the turnover.
McNeil and McCroskey in the game for Syracuse, along with Edlin, Warwick, and Pace. Here's Pace guarded by the freshman, Brown. Edlin. McCroskey for three. And the weak side rebound goes to Brown. Now Hill down the lane, and he draws a foul at the top of the key. How about Shannon Brown, though, the freshman? He's a jumping bean.
He really is.
I mean, he can get up there.
Much bounce to the ounce, and he's fearless as well. A hard worker. His upside is tremendous. And I think he would really thrive in a more open court game. But to run the floor and score in transition, you have to defend and rebound first. And those have been areas, problem areas so far for Michigan State, at least on a consistent basis. And now you look at the lineup they've got on the floor. No real post press. Oh, nice move by Anderson.
Reverse layup, and he flipped it up. Gets his own rebound, triple pump. Got it off the back of the rim and in. Beautifully done
paid
by Anderson.
Yes.
Michigan State trying to creep back into this game. 21-15, Syracuse. Now Warwick wants it on the wing, facing. Edelin, fadeaway jumper, got it.
You love to watch him work, don't you, partner?
Oh, man, this kid is nice. He's got a nice old school game. Brown, bring it up. Shannon Brown with 6 points. Two threes, 23-18, Syracuse. Here's Edlin again. Backing his way down. That one rims off. Andreas with the rebound. Then he throws it away.
Let's take a look at Akeem Ward. Double teamed, but is able to get it to the weak side. And now you've got a one-on-one situation for Billy Edlin. Notice how he went into the defender so he could feel him before he finished it.
Here's Edlin, under eight to play. Looking for Warwick, short baseline. Spins baseline, kept it high. Edlin with the rebound. Missed the layup, but somehow it's tapped up and in.
That was Jeremy McNeil.
Rejected by McNeil on the other end. McNeil working both ends of the floor, and Syracuse takes over again. .7:31 to play, 25-18 Orange. Summary, Syracuse shooting 56% here in the first half with 7:31 to go. Gus Johnson along with Clark Kellogg, and it looks like this is all Syracuse, but Michigan State is only 7 down.
They're only a couple of possessions down. Syracuse has done a nice job dominating action and scoring in the paint with those 14 points in the paint. But Michigan State has had just enough timely three-point shooting to stay in contact. The key for Michigan State is they've got to do a better job defending in the paint. A couple of dribble drives, chip in here or there, and then I think they've got to really try to attack before the zone sets up whenever they get a stop in a defensive board and try to get some scores in transition.
As you take a look at the scoring drop, Syracuse 2-for-7 after starting 8-for-11. 25-18. Here's McNamara along with Warwick, Pace, Fort, and Edelin. Pace penetrates and hits the floater. 6 points for Pace. He's 3-for-3. Great position by Davis, and he's fouled. And he got down the floor quickly, beat his man to the spot, and will head to the free throw line. And the foul called on Warwick is second. So Paul Davis, another one of those Mr. Basketballs from the state of Michigan that has traveled to East Lansing as he gets the first one to go.
You take a look at the difference in statistics for Paul Davis, wins versus losses. The scoring is about the same. Actually, it's up in the losses, rebounding marginally up. But the field goal percentage, a big difference there. So again, with Paul Davis, it's a matter of him just continuing to be assertive and aggressive when he gets touches. His team needs him to be a presence scoring the ball.
Davis hustling for the rebound, has it taken away, and Pace banks it in. Syracuse very aggressive on the offensive glass, and they take a 9-point lead.
And they've got guards that glassy. Josh Pace is listed as a forward, but in size he's a guard. And Billy Edlin will get in there and grab a few boards as well.
There's Pace. Junior from Griffin, Georgia. 8 points, perfect from the field. He was a big key in their championship run last year.
He was very effective, shot well over 60% from the floor. Could defend a couple of different positions as well as share some of the ball handling responsibility.
Shannon Brown off the heel of the rim. Oh. Hager going up high. And a new shot clock. Hill down the lane. And that one out of bounds will stay right here. Tonight on a special CBS movie presentation, action, adventure, romance, Antonio Banderas, Anthony Hopkins, and Catherine Zeta-Jones. star in the blockbuster hit, The Mask of Zorro, tonight at 8:30, 7:30 Central on CBS. Hill inside Davis. Beautiful move and one.
What a terrific job by Chris Hill to use the ball fake to create a passing angle to Paul Davis. Watch the ball. Actually, we weren't able to see it, but he made a ball fake that froze the defender, and Paul Davis was able to get position. From up top, it's still a pleasing view for Tom Izzo and the Spartans. Good, strong catch and finish by Paul Davis. And was that Hakeem Ward?
Yes, his third
foul. And Jim Boeheim not having much confidence in his young backup front court players, rolled the dice a little bit there with Hakeem Ward, and now he'll have to sit the rest of the half with three fouls.
Terrence Roberts comes into the game now for Syracuse. Roberts, a freshman from Jersey City, St. Anthony's High School, Evelyn down the lane.
He's never in a hurry, but he gets where he wants to when he wants to get there.
Billy Evelyn, ball rejected. Ager gets it back. The kick. Shannon Brown finds Hill wide open. Put it on the board. Chris Hill. And the Spartans refuse to go away. 31-25. Syracuse.
Well, I like the way Michigan State is continuing to fight, but they've got to get a little tougher on loose balls and scores in the paint and on the glass. A good, big, strong rebound there by Shannon Brown.
Inside, well, Davis finds a wide open Brown. And fourth with a nice rebound. Long outlet pass, McNamara. He's got pace. Bumped up, count it, and the foul. The Orangemen can really get up and down quickly.
They do a nice job rebounding out of the zone and then running after they rebound. Here's McNamara putting a lot of pressure on the defense. A two-on-one, a good angle taken by Josh Pace. And Chris Hill commits the foul. If you're going to make that foul, Gus, you've got to wrap the guy up so he can't get it up on the window. You got to get him around the shoulder so he can't get a shot up.
And sometimes you see the basic fundamentals played at such a high level. Jerry McNamara stopping at the free throw line, making the bounce pass, and Pace keeping things wide to get to the basket.
You sound like you hooped a little bit in your day.
A little bit.
Yeah, you're right. That was textbook execution of the two-on-one. The guy running the lane, as you said, stayed wide, then a nice, simple bounce pass.
Pace adds the free throw. Sterling performance by Pace in the first half, 11 points. He's 5 for 5, under 5 minutes to go. Anderson down the lane, nice look, rejected, and Namath will go to the line and shoot two. Drew Namath. Fouled by Terrence Roberts. We'll make that McNeil. So Drew Namath, a freshman, 6'10", from Muskegon, Michigan, gets the first one to go. When you look at some of the players that Coach Izzo and Coach Boeheim have had during their stays, it's kind of like a who's who, especially Coach Izzo over the last 5 to 7 years.
Some terrific players have rolled through both of these programs. Mateen, Cleaves, Morris, Peterson on that 2000 NCAA championship team for Michigan State. When you think about Carmelo Anthony, now with the Denver Nuggets.
Anderson, nice, left it for a roll. Wow. Torbert got up so high.
He surprised Jeremy McNeil, who actually got a piece of that ball at the top, but it still found its way to the hoop.
Edelin, stutter step on the baseline, a blocking foul coming up against Michigan State. But just to go back, even other players, Jason Richardson for Michigan State, Zach Randolph. Josh Pace having a nice first half.
He really is, as efficient as he can be. Hasn't missed a shot. Loves to shoot the little floater in the lane. Here he is, just going to wrestle it away from Paul Davis. He didn't really have much leverage being on the floor like that. Pace came and took it right away from him.
As Edelin makes the free throw, Ager picked up his second foul. Edelin with 9 points. Missed the second, it's short. Namath with the rebound. Johnson quickly into the front court. Inside, knocked away by Roberts. Edelin. Make that Roberts diving for it. He's tied up and will stay on this end. 3:42 to go in the first half. 35-29, Syracuse with the lead over Michigan State.
Boy, you get the feeling that Syracuse should be up by much more. They actually were up by 11 just a few moments ago. But the three-point shot allowing Michigan State to kind of hang around.
35-29, Syracuse with the lead over Michigan State. 3:42 to go in the first half. Gus Johnson, Clark Kellogg with you from the dome in Syracuse. And here comes McNamara with Pace, Roberts, Edelin, and McNeil. Hakeem Warwick has three fouls. He's on the bench for the Orangemen. Here's Edelin spinning. Down the lane, tipped up and in. McNeil. McNeil with 4 points. Anderson dumps it down. Namath tipped up and in, though, by Torbert. Torbert crashing the boards, has 6 points now off the bench.
Well, he's rotated a double-digit scoring game with a single-digit scoring game all season long. They need more consistency from him. He's kind of an ideal guy to have coming off your bench, Gus, because he's versatile, and he can give you some energy, and he can produce points without necessarily having plays called for him, just like he did there on the putback.
Kelvin Torbert picking up the loose change and depositing it. 37-31. Coming up on Singular at the Half, Bonnie Bernstein and Bill Raftery, the governor, will update you on all of today's scores and highlights. Plus, the newest member of our CBS Sports College basketball team, Seth Davis, will start to spin the coaching carousel. That's all coming up on Singular at the Half. Now look at the backcourt for Syracuse today. McNamara, slow, but Pace and Edelin are cooking.
They really are. Pace having a huge first half with 11. He typically doesn't score that much in the course of a full game, but he takes advantage of whatever opportunities are there. And this threesome is really efficient, effective, and excellent in how they run things. Their assist to turnover ratio is 2-1 as a threesome, and they also have as many steals almost as turnovers as a threesome. 49 turnovers and 51 steals as a threesome. So that's pretty good perimeter play.
Here's McNamara. Been very patient, hasn't forced any shots up, although he's the second leading scorer on this team. Michigan State paying a lot of attention. He gets that one away. Off the heel of the rim, Edelin with the board. McNamara reloads. Counter. Jerry McNamara. And Syracuse takes a 9-point lead.
I think that matches their largest lead, Gus, of 9 earlier.
Certainly does. Shannon Brown, ball reversal, Hill. Anderson frees himself, Hill again. Got it. Chris Hill. But if Chris Hill could just put it on the floor, a couple of dribbles and rise, he would be such an effective player.
Yeah, that's something he's got to continue to work on, and I know he will during the course of this season and into the offseason. But he's a terrific catch and shoot guy. And up until then, he hadn't had very many good looks, but he's cashed in on the ones that he has got.
Pace inside, off balance shot, snatched down by Andreas. Here comes Hill. And a timeout called by the Orange. 1:20 to play in the first half. 40-34 Syracuse. Don't forget, tomorrow the road to the Super Bowl runs through Naptown. That's right, Indianapolis and Denver. 4:30 Eastern Time tomorrow. It all begins at 4 o'clock with the NFL Today. Jim Nantz, Dion, Boomer, Dan, and company. And here's the matchup. Last time these two teams met a couple of weeks ago, Denver thumped Indianapolis in Indy. And Peyton Manning, the co-MVP with Steve McNair, will be looking to do it a little differently this time around. 1:20 remaining in the first half. Gus Johnson and Clark Kellogg from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. 40-34, the Orange lead the Spartans.
Well, it's been the three-point shot that has allowed Michigan State to stay as close as they are. The lead has been as high as 9, but it's basically hovered between 5 and 9 points most of the half. And Michigan State, talking about that three-point shooting, they've made 5 of 11 from behind the arc.
Hill, the kick, Torbert sets his feet. Short pace, knocked away out of bounds, and we'll head the other way. And a foul has been called against the Spartans.
Wow, I thought he got all orange there. Ager attacking the rebounder.
And that's his third.
Boy, he did get a lot of the orange there. And I thought Jim Burr was just calling the ball out to Syracuse, but a foul was whistled.
Well, Jim Burr actually did. It was Ed Corbett who called the foul. He was on the sideline as Shannon Brown comes back in. And Ager heads to the bench after picking up his third. Pace misses the first. Here's the second. Off the mark. Loose ball. Rebounding. It's Hill. Michigan State. They can get a little closer. As time winds down in the first half. Spartans shooting 38% inside. Anderson leaves it. And that's one thing about Anderson. He's a little too unselfish.
Yeah. You catch it in there, Gus. You've got to be thinking score. I understand he has a nice ability to pass it, but you catch it that deep, you've got to think about scoring the ball there. It was a good idea, but again, you can get a high-quality shot when you catch it down there in the paint like that.
And Edelin will take his time. As we'll just call this kid old school.
You know what I call a guy like him?
What?
Old school.
Old school.
Because he combines the young and the old. Right. There you go. I was waiting for you to finish that off for me, partner.
Edelin to Roberts. Brown the other way. And he steps on the baseline.
There he is. Always under control. Drive, draw, and drop a dime.
Billy Edelin allows Syracuse to go up 42-34.
Plays his game low to the ground. No extra motion. Very efficient. And loves to play.
Yes, he does.
I mean, you talk to him, you can just tell. He loves to be out there. That's a neat quality to have. McNamara has it. Warwick, I mean, they just love being out here trying to play.
Yeah, they're checking to see when the clock actually stopped. As Edelin finds Roberts, who jammed it down. Spartans came the other way. And right there. Should be about 1.8, I would imagine. Clock right now reading 0.2 seconds. 42-34 Syracuse. And maybe even a little more.
You think a little more than?
I'm not
0.7?
Sure.
0.8?
Maybe. Yeah, probably about 1.8, I would imagine.
Well, I don't think it's that much, partner.
No?
No. Hey, Kate, matter of fact.
Let's see. They're going to leave it there.
Oh, they did put 2. Oh, you're right, Gus.
Okay, 2 seconds remaining. And here comes 4th, who inbound on the baseline. Throws it into the front court. Pace with the catch. Got it up and hit it. Holy Toledo. Where's Grant Hill and Christian Laettner when you need them?
They're going to have to take a look at this. A new rule. Actually, it happened in the Syracuse game last year where a shot went in after the buzzer. And before this year, you weren't allowed to look at a halftime buzzer beater, but now you can. Let's see.
That's a hoop.
That's a hoop, folks. Clock doesn't start until he catches. There's the catch. One bounce. That's like the ATM, cash money all day long. Boy, and what a devastating turn of events for the Spartans. They had scratched and clawed to within six, then turned it over on their last possession. Had a dunk made by Terrence Roberts, and then with 2 seconds added to the clock, they're able to get this shot to go up and down. Oh, it's clear. I mean, that's elementary, Watson. It
certainly is. They need it all of the 2 seconds as well. And the basket counts.
Wow.
So Syracuse has its largest lead of the game as Jim Boeheim has a quick chat with Jim Burr. 44-34 Syracuse. That's the end of the first half. Now let's go to Bonnie Bernstein in New York. Welcome back to the Carrier Dome, where the Syracuse Orange men lead the Spartans of Michigan State 44-34. Gus Johnson along with Clark Kellogg. Your impressions of that first half?
Well, I thought Syracuse did a nice job defensively in the zone, but they also were very effective at the offensive end, in part because they got high quality shots, Gus. Anytime you shoot a good percentage, that means you're making the shots you take, but you're also getting good shots. That's Ward. He didn't score much, but he knocked one down there. Michigan State just kind of hanging around because of the three-point shot. They made 5 of 11. But the dominating part of the game was right there. Syracuse doing it in the paint. And you take a look at the big three for Michigan State on the year. That represents, on average, about 32 points a game. So far, they're only at 15. And they need more from those guys. But defensively, I think, is where Michigan State has to make their biggest adjustment. When you get dominated in the paint like that, it's going to be hard to win. I mean, they got outscored 28 to 12 points in the paint.
Here's Anderson along with Torbert, who starts the second half. Davis, Andreas, and Hill inside. Torbert backs it out. Now Davis, weak side, Anderson wide open. And Edelin comes up with the rebound.
Well, that's good basketball, though, Gus. Once you move it around, get the defense moving, and you get it to the high post area, you need to look opposite because the shot should be available, and that's a good look for Allen Anderson.
Lob, Warwick somehow catches it off the glass, and he draws the foul. Hakeem a little frustrated in early foul trouble. Only has 5 points, leads for the team in scoring the 20 per game, and he'll head to the line.
Well, they picked up his third foul with about 6 minutes to go. As you take a look at him doing a nice job adjusting to the pass after it was a little off the mark, and then frustrated that he didn't finish after being fouled.
As he misses the first free throw.
Syracuse would have a much larger lead. They only made 7 of their 13 free throws at halftime, shooting only 60% from the line so far as a team this year.
Largest lead of the game for the Orangemen, 45-34. They get back in that patented zone, knocked away by Pace, picked up by Forth. He's tied up. We'll head the other way. The Spartans getting a little lazy with the basketball.
That's been a problem. We talked about it at the top of this telecast. 19 turnovers a game in their 5 losses. They had 7 in the first half here today, while Syracuse only had 3 turnovers.
McNamara. How about that? Kid is tough as nails. Torbert the other way, knocked away, stolen by Pace. McNamara got a hand on it. Here's Pace. Penetrate. Here's Mack. Put it on the board. Jerry McNamara. Timeout Spartans. Syracuse running Michigan State out of the gym. Syracuse with the 50-34 lead, and as they say, Clark, if you got a J, you can play.
And Jerry has a J, and he's been the catalyst for this mini surge to start the second half. Back-to-back buckets, one of them a three on the heels of a Hakeem Warwick free throw, so it's 6-0. Syracuse to start this half. You look at McNamara's numbers, he was under wraps pretty much in that first half, but he found some daylight here in the first 2 minutes, well, minute and a half of this second half, and the Orangemen started the game with a 9-0 run, and now they start the second half with a 6-0 run. And you look at the points off turnovers, another huge factor today. And Syracuse winning that game hands down.
Another turnover by the Spartans. 10 turnovers for 15 Syracuse points off turnovers. Warren, the kick back out the Pace. Now Hakeem in the pivot. Pulls up. Short. Ford battling. Pace with the tip. It won't go. Hill the other way. Andreas. Babied it. Now Edelin on the move down the lane. From Pace. 52-34 Syracuse.
And if you can't dribble penetrate and you're not strong with the ball, you better make perimeter shots against the zone defense.
Star Search, TV's original talent show, is back with a brand new twist. See challengers take on past champions in the winner's circle. Arsenio Hall hosts the all-new Star Search, premiering Saturday, January 17th on CBS. McNamara, double clutch, rims out. Shannon Brown clears it. Now Hill in the front court. Anderson rejected. Fourth into the hands of Pace. Too strong. McNamara with a rebound. Here comes Jerry. Nice look. Pace off the glass. Got it. And the foul. The national champions aren't fooling around.
They're bringing it, guys. Oh. 3-on-1. Nice look away pass. McNamara to Pace. And all three of these guys, they're perimeter guys. Pace, Edlin, and McNamara don't mind contact. They invite it, especially when they get driving lanes. Pace doing it there, expecting it, receiving and absorbing it, and then finishing.
Pace has the free throw. Just imagine if they had that other supposed sophomore playing with them this year. Number 15.
That'd be a scary thought.
Holy mackerel. 11-0 run for the Orange. In the corner, Brown. Anderson back to Torbert. Dumps it down. Great look, Torbert. And Davis slams it home. To 36. Syracuse.
How can Michigan State get back in this game? They've been unable to contain penetration. And there you see Warren getting inside again. They just haven't been able to resist or offer resistance to anything Syracuse has done offensively. And while the Orangemen haven't gotten a lot of offensive rebounds, when they have gotten them, they've scored.
Michigan State successful, though, on that dump down last couple of possessions. 57-38. Now McNamara rising. Out of bounds. Timeout on the floor. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA men's basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
teams you won like 675 games or something like that?
Yeah, but you didn't win that big one.
You've won it now, my
and
friend.
We've won it now.
Yeah, congratulations.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Jim Boeheim, everybody.
Monday on an all-new late show. Dave welcomes actress Jennifer Aniston, plus music from Ryan Adams, and an all-new Top 10 Monday right here on CBS, where all the stars have a chance to talk to Dave. Jim Boeheim, one of those stars after winning the national championship. And Coach Boeheim is so interesting. He's one of the great characters in the game of college basketball. He never gets too excited.
Right.
His team is never really that good.
But he's a realist. I mean, when you talk to him, he's candid, he's direct. I mean, I know sometimes people feel like he's not as forthcoming, but he really understands the game and knows players. And I've always respected how he allows his players to play. He's always done that. He doesn't make it too complicated. He keeps it very simple. And that's why he's had such long-term success.
Inside Edelin, turnaround jump shot, short. Rebounded by Torbert. Here come the Spartans.
Now, one of the things about Syracuse playing with this kind of lead, they still will look to attack and maybe get comfortable to the point of taking quick shots. And Michigan State just has to continue to kind of grind it out. Here you take a look at something we talked about at the top of our show, what had happened statistically in Michigan State's five losses coming into today's game. Well, the numbers that have been significant, the rebound differential, turnovers, and the field goal percentage defense, and those numbers at this point in the game pointing to another loss, but there's still plenty of time to go if Michigan State can find a way to tighten things up defensively. They've been effective here the last few possessions, Gus, getting the ball inside to Davis, and he's been able to score. Now can they create enough with their defense to get scoring opportunities at the other end?
Michigan State has trailed by as many as 21. Currently on a 6-0 run as Syracuse turns the ball over. That's only their fourth turnover of the game.
Well, I like what Tom Izzo has done here in that he has Shannon Brown, Torbert, and Maurice Ager on the floor. It's basically four around one, with Paul Davis being the only interior presence. But it should help them shore up their perimeter defense and allow them to be able to pressure a little more at the defensive end of the floor.
Extra pass, Torbert gets to the bucket, reverse layup a little too strong. And here comes Pace. Inside, Ford can't make the catch, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, I call them PIPs, points in the paint, PIP, and it's been all Syracuse so far today.
Where's Gladys?
There's Akeem. And there are the numbers, although Michigan State has closed the gap a little bit here in their last few possessions because Paul Davis has been able to find room inside.
Davis once again.
See, this move to go four around one has freed up space for Paul Davis, and it's forced Syracuse to come out on the perimeter a little more to try to contain dribble penetration. And Paul Davis doing major work here the last four trips down the court for Michigan State.
Davis with 17, Pace pulls up the leader. It's not pretty, but very effective. Now Brown down low, Ager power dribble and draws the foul.
Well, that's a terrific early attack by Shannon Brown.
So
it's been all Davis so far in this second half for Michigan State.
As Ager gets the first one, and Reese hasn't been shooting it too well lately. As you take a look at all his last five games against UCLA, 3 of 14, only two attempts against Coppin State.
He's warmed up today. I mean, that's a big improvement on 19%, which is what he shot in his last five. But sometimes a guy like that needs to knock down a perimeter shot or get something easy, a layup in transition, get some foul shots to kind of get himself going a little bit.
Now Edelin starts the offense on the wing. Here's the screen. Down the lane, the floater.
And that's up against a pretty good defender in Shannon Brown.
Hill wide open. Trying to answer McNeil with the two-handed rebound. Here comes Billy the Kid in the front court to McNamara. And Davis with the swooping rebound. 61-46. Syracuse. Davis has been a workhorse. Brown to the bucket. Jams it down. Matador defense by the Orangemen.
Well, they got lost as far as matching up. And Jim not too pleased about it. But Michigan State a little more comfortable at this pace. The zone defense hasn't been able to get set up. Boy, tough foul inside.
Warwick. Bang. But if you're Tom Izzo, you don't mind banging Hakeem Warwick that way, do you?
No, exactly. That's part of what you try to do as an opposing coach or team is be physical with Warwick.
Inside Edelin. This kid is a good player, folks. Watch out for Billy Edelin. Only a sophomore, has 15 points inside. And that's Hager. He's starting to warm up a bit as well. 63-50. Syracuse, under 12 to go. Inside, Warwick. And a whistle foul on the floor coming up against the Spartans. Timeout, 11:44 to play in the second half. Syracuse with the 63-50 lead. 63-50, Syracuse with the lead over Michigan State. Take a look at the Syracuse backcourt today. Pace with 18, McNamara with 11, Edelin with 15.
Those are some nice numbers. You look at the assists, rebounds, stuffing the stat sheet, high shooting percentage across the board. That's a threesome. Those kind of numbers can get you a lot of W's. The thing for Syracuse is they've got to continue to attack, but also show a little more discretion. With this lead, Michigan State playing four round one with four perimeter guys, Ager, Henderson, Hill, and Brown around Davis. Oh, that's too easy. My goodness.
Warwick on the inbounds. Edelin finding it. And the lead grows to 15. Down by Brown. Shannon Brown banks it home. 65-52. Michigan State still in this game if they can, especially if they can come up with some stops on the defensive end.
That's the answer right there. I mean, they're scoring, and I think they're more comfortable playing at a quicker pace, but that pace has been born out of desperation. When you go down 20 in the second half, you need to throw all caution to the wind.
Trail by as many as 21. Warwick looking inside, five on the shot clock. McNamara will fire. Jerry McNamara. 68-52. Syracuse. And Mac now with 14 points. Inside. Nice look. Great catch by Davis. He's fouled. It'll go to the line. And that's the fourth foul on fourth.
Let's take a look at Paul Davis. He's not paying attention to where Warwick is. He's got his head turned to the ball. You've got to see them both. And on a baseline out of bounds play, that's a bad mistake. And then McNamara fighting the shot clock. You and I talked to him prior to the game, Gus. He is all business. All he's about is he really is about taking care of his business. And he loved to take shots like the one he just took. Late in the shot clock, game on the line, a chance to change momentum.
He talked to us before the game about how instrumental his father was in developing him into the player that he is, working with him for countless hours growing up in Scranton on his game, especially that patented jump shot.
He also talked about trying to become more proficient at creating shots for himself off the dribble.
Warren chasing down his own rebound out of bounds. Comes Hill along with Anderson, Shannon Brown, Ager, and Paul Davis. Davis single-handedly has kept Michigan State in this game in the second half. Skip pass, Brown. Hill down the lane, rejected by McNeil. But that's what you want to see Chris Hill do.
Yeah, you're right, Gus. And again, after ball movement, the seam is available. The ball's been swung. Guys are off balance and out of position. Put it on the floor. Get into that seam and try to get some offense going. A nice job there by Chris Hill to take what was available and not settle for a catch and shoot.
Now Edelin guarded by Brown. Edelin penetrates. Got Shannon Brown up in the air and draws a foul. Paul Davis has been working hard in the second half for the Spartans.
Not only working hard, but working well. Finding the open spot in the zone and finishing with authority. And again, when Tom Izzo went to the four round one setup, it created a lot more space for Paul Davis to operate. There's not another big body in there. And Syracuse, not a very big team. Hakeem Warwick is long, O'Neal is thick and a high riser, but after that, they're smallish up front and can be taken advantage of inside.
And look at this line on Edelin. 17.7 assists, four rebounds. McNeil stripped it. Hill, the kick, Ager. Should have gotten a call on that. Looked like Ager was fouled. But that one, an air ball right out of bounds.
Well, I thought he just lost it, Gus.
Was that what happened?
That's what it appeared to be. That appeared to be the case from my vantage point.
Now McNamara the other way. Whites out. Davis with the rebound. Here comes Spartans. Ager strong to the bucket. This time he lays it up and in and the foul.
Well, the Michigan State Spartans had numbers because McNamara is out of your picture after that drive and miss. He looked for the foul, didn't get it, and Michigan State wisely attacked and had a man advantage and got it to Ager on the fly for the hoop and the foul.
Couple of subs coming in for the Spartans. Drew Namick as well as Timbo Gracchus both coming into the game.
Nice aggressive take here by Maurice Ager. And I talked about how a guy who has struggled with his perimeter shot can sometimes get himself going by attacking the rim.
Namick saves it from going out of bounds right into the hands of Warren. Lobbing it inside McNeil. And Edelin putting a little too much on that pass.
Probably his first turnover, but right now Syracuse keeping the door open for Michigan State because they're not quite as efficient as they were in the first half.
So let's see, 8:33 to go in the second half. A field goal here, and you got a 10-point game.
But sometimes,
and
Gus,
Michigan State, you feel you got them right where you want.
Yeah. But when you have to fight so hard to come back from huge deficits, you wonder if you have enough juice to finish it off.
So instead of a 10-point game, Hill makes it a 9-point game. And let's see if Syracuse does the Archie Bell and the drills. The tighten up.
Believe you went there on me
from Houston,
Archie.
Texas.
Tighten it
I don't think it'll happen.
Oh, man.
I'm working with you, man. I had to bring out my
inventory, brother. Oh, you went long and deep for that one.
Pogrekis picks up the foul. 8:04 to go in the second half, 70-61. And a whistle. Foul coming up against the Spartans.
And that's the 17th foul, Gus, which means Syracuse, even though they're a poor free throw shooting team, will have opportunities at the line as we go through the final 8 minutes. And you know Michigan State being behind, they'll have to be aggressive and they'll be more prone to fouling. So a tough foul there.
Yes.
And a bad one because there was no real advantage.
Syracuse on the season shooting 59% from the line as a team as Warren gets the first. McKean 5 of 7 from the free throw line today. There's a second. Got a nice bounce. 72-61. Inside, Anderson rises and hits. Allen Anderson found a soft spot in the Syracuse zone. Makes it a 9-point ball game. Michigan State continues to fight. And McNamara twists his ankle on the sideline. McNamara being shadowed, I believe, by Ager. And a timeout called by the Orange. 7:41 to play, 72-63, Syracuse. All right, Bonnie, our score here, 72-63 Syracuse, as we look at the game summary.
Well, you take a look at the numbers. Michigan State has closed the gap in regards to the points in the paint scoring because Paul Davis has been terrific in the second half. And I really think strategically, when Tom Izzo went to the four perimeter guys around Davis, it freed him up to get more touches, and it also allowed them to do a little better job of dribble penetrating. And as a result, they've scored. They had 34 points at halftime, Gus. They've scored 29 already here, and we've got almost 8 minutes to go. So the quicker pace and also the personnel that Izzo has had on the floor, I think, has made a difference.
Not a good sign for this Syracuse team. McNamara on the bench, sitting next to Jim Boeheim. He twisted his ankle. Now Mac getting up off the bench. He'll check back in. Edelin and Pace, though, along with Warwick, McCroskey. McNeil, Pace, leans in, continues to have a career day offensively. 20 points for Pace on 9 of 11 shooting.
And everything's been around the goal or in the paint. Those little half shots that he and Eaton have mastered.
Here's Ager. Spartans, they get it to Hill on the rebound of the basket, and he gets the roll. Chris Hill starting to take the ball to the basket, and it's proving to be very effective for Michigan State. Warren, guarded by Anderson. Across the lane, dumps it down, and a foul. Billy Eagle has been playing some serious basketball today.
Yeah, he does it at such a comfortable pace, too. He never rushes. He's always going about 35 miles an hour and just gets where he wants to go. He's got all the flips and tricks, but I think the big thing with him is his strength. The fact that he likes contact, he can handle it, and he can still finish plays. And he plays low to the ground. He's rarely out of control. And that allows him to make good passes as well as take good high percentage shots.
9-point lead. Ball stolen away by McNamara. He finds Edelin straight to the bucket. Here at the Carrier Dome. Torbert. And he's fouled. And
Coming up, it's two scoops of women's basketball. Next, Duke's takes on top dog UConn, then later South Carolina battles Minnesota. And the Duke men and women both number one. The Connecticut men and women both number one. '76-'65 inside and beautiful touch.
Well, Michigan State doing a much better job here in the second half attacking the zone. They found the soft spot right in the middle at about the foul line area or a little below, and they've been able to get it to Paul Davis behind the zone. Where they haven't quite lifted their game enough is at that end of the floor, Gus.
Warwick with the drop step on the baseline. 78-67. Hager and Olsen.
Take a look at Warwick going to work against the smaller Allen Anderson, who did a pretty good job defensively there, but just was unable to jump and challenge the shot. And Ward knows that and takes him right to the hoop.
If you're a smaller guy like Anderson, how do you guard a Ward who wants to use his strength and his size to get to the basket?
Well, you need some help from teammates in terms of ball pressure, so the pass into the post isn't that easy. And the other thing is you have to utilize your quickness, break contact, and try to keep the post player from catching the ball by running. If you let him catch it and try to resist him from behind, it's a problem.
Anderson answering on the other end, and now the lead down to 8 with 5 minutes to go. And we've got a foul against Anderson guarding Warwick, and Akeem will go over the line. Warwick shooting 1-1. Of 8 on the day. Gets the first one to go. Saw Akeem yesterday at the Varsity, one of the great restaurants in Syracuse, as he gets the second. And you can tell he's been working out because the young man's got a great appetite. He was knocking down those Varsity burgers. Here's Anderson. 80-70, Syracuse, the national champions, leading at home. Anderson fires, short. Torbert had it, rebounded by Pace. Outlet McNamara took his eyes off of it.
And a good thing he did for Michigan State, because Syracuse clearly had numbers and were in great position to add to their lead.
Here's Edelin.
He's got the taller Paul Davis on him here.
Double pump, jump hook, got it.
Made no difference.
Young man is an athlete, folks. Timeout Spartan. 4:01 to go. 82-70 Orange. Carmelo's gone, but Syracuse isn't.
And that guy right there, Akeem Warwick, has shown up big here in the last 5 minutes.
He told me that he talks to his buddy Melo on a regular basis, and that Carmelo would be watching this game, saying, and he said that this was an important win for the Orange. He challenged his former teammates to play big, and they have. Down low, Davis, saved by Warwick, picked up off the floor by Ager. Hill, catch and shoot, off the side rim. Tarbert got up, but somehow McNamara comes up with the ball. And a foul, Pace, grabbed by Hill and taken to the floor.
Boy, Chris Hill just didn't recognize what he had available to him, which was namely the basketball right in his lap. and he just didn't recognize it and committed a foul. Pace is shaken up a bit. He hit the deck hard. He's had a magnificent game today. And you take a look. See, Hill turns his back on the ball, and then when he catches it, he doesn't realize all he needs to do is squeeze it. But he thought that Pace was going to get to it before him because he didn't know where it was. It was right in front of Chris Hill. He needed to just get it and move on. But instead, he felt as though he needed to keep Pace from it and pushed him and committed the foul.
What a game, though. You're right for Pace. 20 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists. And here comes a sub into the game for the Orange. It's Ronil Heron, senior, and he'll shoot the free throws. How about this? Whatever you need, coach. No problem, coach.
The walk-on stepping in as a free throw specialist.
Anything you need, coach. 3:35 to go. 84-70, Syracuse. Syracuse, 3:35 to go in the second half. Let's check out the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. The backcourt for Syracuse.
53 total points. They've shot a high percentage from the floor. Timely three-point shooting from McNamara.
Get complete game stats at CBSSportsline.com. There's Pace, who's had a career day. 20 points for Pace. McNamara, another solid outing. He has 14. And Billy Edelin, 19 points, 7 assists, 4 rebounds.
Stat sheet stuffer.
Stat sheet stuffer.
And you look at this game as it winds down here. Michigan State needs to knock down some threes. Time here.
Brown frees himself and hits the baby jump shot.
Well, I like the way this young man plays. He's long and strong, big hands, long arms, very athletic, unafraid. Adair picked up a foul on Eaton, riding him along the hip. But I like his energy level and his work ethic. He really wants to be a player. He's going to continue to earn more and more minutes for Tom Izzo this season.
As Edelin misses the first free throw.
That's the only chink in his armor.
I was just about to say that. His free throw shooting. Edelin. And even 20 now. On the season, Billy. A 44% free throw shooter and a travel called against Michigan State. Now McNamara. What I like the versatility for Syracuse. You have three guys that handle the ball extremely well. Edelin straight to the basket. Pace can handle it. Edelin can handle it. McNamara can handle it.
And they don't turn it over much.
Ager, he's broken out of his shooting slump. 2:38 to go in the second half, 87-75. 87-75, let's reset it for you. Syracuse, 4 timeouts left. Michigan State down to only 1. Syracuse in the double bonus. Gus Johnson, Clark Kellogg with you. From the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York.
Well, at the top, Gus, we wondered how much man-to-man Syracuse would play. They had shown a lot more up until this game than they had in prior years. And the zone was the defensive choice, and it's been very effective. And you think about it, Michigan State really only has one outstanding three-point shooter. That's Chris Hill. in light of the fact that Maurice Ager had been struggling coming into this game. And the zone really allowed Syracuse to jump out to a quick lead. And then I think it was just the efficiency of their perimeter guys that took over from there.
McNamara stolen away by Davis. Here comes Hill. And Hill fouled from behind by McNamara.
Well, not a good series for Jerry McNamara there as he turns it over, something he hasn't done much of all season, and then compounds the error with the foul, which is the last thing you want to do. If you're Syracuse, you don't want to give Michigan State a chance to carve into the lead with the clock stop. And he knows it.
And Hill misses the front end. Rebounded by the Spartans, blocked by Pace. Into the hands of Fort. To Pace, lobs it, Warwick! Hakeem Warwick from Pace, 89-75. And he's right at his season's average of 20. Weak side, catch and shoot. Shannon Brown and Edelin with another rebound.
Well, we've talked an awful lot about Josh Pace, Billy Edelin, and Jerry McNamara, but Hakeem Warwick has stepped up in the second half, 15 of his 20 here in the second half. And in transition, where Syracuse has been able to hurt Michigan State a number of times, up top we go with Hakeem for the gentle two.
Four players in double figures for the Orangemen. Hill for three. Got it. Timeout Spartans. 1:18 to play. 89-78 Orange. And another look at the game reset. 1:18 to go. No timeouts remaining for Michigan State. 89-78 Syracuse with the lead. Gus Johnson, Clark Kellogg with you from the Carrier Dome. Jerry McNamara, Billy Edelin, and Josh Pace, along with Hakeem Warwick, have been oh so solid in this game.
They've been outstanding. It took Warwick until the second half. He had to sit 6 minutes of the first with three fouls, but he's been dominant in the second half.
Jerry McNamara along with Pace and Billy Edelin, the three-headed guard monster or monster guards for the Orange. As Warwick missed the first, let's take a look at their numbers, all in double figures.
Wow, how about the shooting between Pace and Edelin? 18 of 24. That is 75%, Gus. And McNamara with some timely threes to give Syracuse a nice cushion as they started this second half. And Warwick has been able to do damage inside.
Davis, an air ball. Warwick with the rebound to McNamara, all alone. Pace elevates and bangs it home. Seconds to go. 92-78. 92 points for Syracuse. And the tip jam goes to Davis. It's a lot of points in a college basketball game.
Well, that's one of the reasons they won the national title a year ago, because they had the ability to score more so than probably 75-80% of the teams in college basketball. And when you've got backcourt guys that can handle, you've got a perimeter shooter in Ward, you've got presence inside, although it's not the traditional presence in a big bulky kind of score that some teams have, but Ward can do damage. You're going to have a tough time simply outscoring this Syracuse team. Even though they're not very deep, they can put numbers up because they score in transition, they can score on the perimeter, and they can get it inside with Ward.
94-80. Syracuse in the corner. Shannon Brown fouled on the release, and he'll shoot three. Not a very wise foul by four. Now the Chevrolet Bulls back players of the game are Paul Davis, 21 points, had a great second half on 7-12 shooting. And Josh Pace, a career high, 22 points on 10 of 12 shooting. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. Here's Davis. As Brown steps to the line. Don't forget, coming up next, women's basketball. Number 4, Duke at number 1, Connecticut. As Brown makes it a 94-83 game. Pace inbounding on the baseline. And a foul coming up against, I believe, Anderson. Fouling Warwick.
Tom Izzo can't be too pleased with the defense, because his team just allowed too many easy scores and dug too deep a hole to come back from against a high-octane offensive team. But he has to be somewhat pleased with the energy and effort in the second half, trying to make a game of it, not giving in, but again, the hole just too deep. And defensively, Michigan State has to amp it up a bit as they get ready for conference play. They'll open up next week against Wisconsin.
McNamara pulls it out, and he will dribble off the clock. Syracuse improves to 9-1. They defeat Michigan State 96-83. For Clark Kellogg, this is Gus Johnson saying so long from the Carrier Dome. Coming up next, it's women's college basketball as number 4 Duke takes on number 1 Connecticut. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the men's NCAA basketball championship.
Well, Jim, a terrific performance by your club today. Talk about what the keys were in your mind.
Well, offensively, Josh and Billy, you know, they're a tough man-to-man team. You got to get dribble penetration, and people are playing Jerry so tough. They just got in the lane, and then the second half, Hakeem came out and, you know, really went after it and did a tremendous job. Our offense was really good. Defensively, we haven't got it going yet, Clark. We're going to have to get better on the defensive end, but Billy and Josh were terrific in the first half tonight.
You talk about your team's defense not being where you want it to be, but offensively, you've got to be excited about the potential that this team has.
Well, our centers stepped up today, Craig and Jerry. When they play well, that really helps us. But, you know, we've got a good group. We got to get our younger guys some more action. This was the first big game. We want to keep our veterans in there. But I think our young guys will get ready and help us as we get out into the conference season.
All right, congratulations. Thanks. Great job.
Thanks, Clark.
Billy, terrific job by not only you, but your team. Talk about what your focus was coming in against a Michigan State team that typically is pretty tough defensively.
Well, we weren't fooled by their record. We knew they played some tough teams, and all their losses were to good opponents. So we wanted to come out. We knew they were physical, and we played them in a tough game last year where we gave Chris Hill like 10 threes, so we wanted to try to limit those.
Talk about your game. It's so efficient, so easy. Was it as easy as it looked out there for you today?
That's just the way I play. I mean, I've been playing like that since I was young, and I try to continue that. But we got a lot of talented players, so there's no need for me to force anything. Just take when it comes.